Hello everyone, welcome you back to the channel Supply Chain Way. And today's discussion is all about warehousing. So if this is the first video if you're watching in the channel, I would suggest you to go back and start with the series Supply Chain Fundamentals, because this video on warehousing is going to be part of that series Supply Chain Fundamentals. So it would be great if you start from the first video, which is what is supply chain, and see all the videos in that playlist, and then you can come in sequence so that you will get a better continuity. Okay, great. So let's get it started. So as said, today's discussion is completely on warehousing. So there are a total of around 8 to 10 videos planned part of this topic, warehousing. So it's going to get you up to speed, starting from knowing about what is a warehouse, what are all the different warehouse processes involved in the operations. Also, very importantly, some of the techniques used in optimizing a warehouse. So I think these are the key agenda part of this session. And specifically in this video, we are going to start with the first question, what is a warehouse? Okay, so the word warehouse is synonymous with the term storage. So warehouse is a building for storing goods, as simple as that. It could be any form of goods. To be very specific, it could be a raw material, it could be a semi-finished goods, or it could be a finished goods. For someone still who didn't understand what is a raw material, what is a semi-finished goods, what is finished good, no worries. Again, as I said, please go back and start from the first video in this series. You will get an understanding. Even if you don't have time to do that, I have a very quick example for you. Just look at this image. You have a raw material, you have a semi-finished good, and you have a finished good. So it's very evident. The wood is the raw material, and the planks of wood are the semi-finished state. And then finally, a dining table with chairs are made, which is the finished good. Okay, so now this relevance you can put it to any other industry or a sector. Okay, so the definition, the warehouse is a building for storing goods. And the goods could be raw material, semi-finished goods, or finished goods. Okay, so very pretty simple, right? So, but post COVID-19, you know what happened? There is a lot of discussions going around warehousing, because though it sounded simple that warehouse is a place to store goods, warehouse gives a competitive edge to an organization. What I mean by competitive edge is if an organization manages their warehouse well in terms of capacity, how they maintain it, or what kind of stocks they are holding, how good they are taking in the products, how good they are servicing orders. If they are able to take care of their warehouse well, that holds an edge over their competition. And 10-15 years before, warehouses never took a center stage like this. 10-15 years before, always the discussion point is on manufacturing. People talked about manufacturing time in seconds, like for example automotive manufacturing, like every 3.5 minutes one car comes out. So people were measuring in minutes within that four walls within a manufacturing facility. But what happened, everyone started doing this process improvements within manufacturing, and it kind of made the stage even for everyone. So that edge is being replaced by warehousing, one of the booming field. And post COVID-19, now people are really worried to rely on the transportation part, because which is the one area which got heavily impacted by COVID-19. So now people started investing more time and energy into getting warehouses done, and also done in a very scientific way. And warehousing is a science. Okay, right, I'll keep talking about it. So let me stop with that preview for now, and let's get it started with the other details within warehousing. So if you talk about warehouse management, you can ask like, what is that is managed within a warehouse? Again, we go back to the same logic of the product cache information. This is the same way how we have seen supply chain management. Within that, what are the things being managed is product cache and information. So similar way, within a warehouse, in terms of product, the flow of product is managed, the storage of product is managed, the preservation and traceability, the very, very important thing within a warehouse. One area where most of the warehouses struggle is preservation and traceability. One of the key requirement within a warehouse, not just within the warehouse, even within the supply chain, preservation and traceability is very, very important. In terms of cash, two key terms you should know, it is OPEX and CAPEX, that is operating expenditure and capital expenditure. Okay, these two are the two things are very important from a warehouse management standpoint. To put it a little more insight to it, operating expenditure is a it's kind of a routine expenses which happens every month. This is kind of your water bills, electricity, the kind of rent what you pay, some of the consumables, all these things which you incur as an expense on a monthly basis, it is kind of your routine expenses. Those becomes your OPEX. CAPEX is kind of a capital expenditure. It could be like investment on some new warehouse management system, investment on some of the racking for storage. All these kind of things will come under the CAPEX. So these two also come under warehouse management under the head of cash. The third one, information, very, very crucial thing. We have inbound inventory and outbound. And in the coming videos, we'll specifically talk about these processes as well. But just to give you a gist of it, inbound starts from the orders going out to the suppliers until you receive the stock. But the job of warehouse actually starts moment the product is received at the gate. Received in the sense the shipment has just arrived. From that, the warehousing's job has started. There could be a thin line. In few cases, the warehouses arranges the delivery to pick up the product as well. So I'm going to keep those kind of exceptions out. In general, moment shipment reaches your warehouse is when the warehouse management's scope of work starts. So the inbound, that means the product is received into the warehouse. Still there, the inbound is there. It starts with the vehicle reaching the facility, and till the time the products are received into the warehouse comes under inbound. Inventories, as I said, taking care of your inventory, accounting your inventory, all those things will come under your inventory part. Outbound is now the orders are received into the warehouse. It could be a sales order, it could be a delivery order, it could be a transfer order, depending on the reason why you are having this warehouse. For example, if this warehouse is shipping to the final customer, then you call that as a sales order. But if this warehouse is going to ship this to another satellite warehouse or an intermediate warehouse or a transit hub, then we call that as a transfer order. Okay, and the outbound starts from receiving of the order. Then you pick the product, pack the product, label the product, invoice the product, you send it to the customer. This complete thing come in the inbound. And all these three form the information vertical within warehouse management. So that's it. Simple. So warehouse management, what do you manage within the warehouse? Product, cash and information. And what do you do within product? What do you do within cash and information? You all note. And the information is a common thing for across, right? But the product role and cash roles will be normally different. Like the product piece is taken care by the operations team, and the cash point mostly it is taken care by the procurement team is also involved here whenever you are going buying new stuff. Also the finance team is involved whenever you are going to pay things out of your warehouse. Okay, so that's about the warehouse management. Now before I wind up this session, I want to give this clarity. One of the questions I have been asked whenever I go for some lectures, this is one question, and it's better I give that clarity before we move forward to some of the toughest topics within warehousing. Godown versus warehouse versus distribution center. When you call a facility as godown, when you call as a facility as a warehouse, when you call a facility as a distribution center, when I mean a facility, a building. So first and foremost thing, as I've said 15 years before, nowhere warehousing is in any form of limelight, and most cases a warehouse is called as a godown. Okay, so this is also a warehouse, this is also storing goods, but it is called as godown when things are not organized. It's not so tidy. Think about a storage where things are just dumped inside and there is no proper way of retrieving storage products. Then you call that as a godown. And warehouse means if you have to call a facility which is intended to do a storage as warehouse, then a building where goods are stored in an organized way with all safety measures in place. Very, very important. It could be a complete safety of material. It is also safety of people. Very, very important. So it includes everything. It includes the way you store products. It includes the way you retrieve products, the way you preserve the products, what kind of equipments you are using. You should not, even ergonomics is considered here. You should even be in a right position when you are handling the product such that your body is not impacted. All these things are covered here. So safety is very, very important. If that is taken care of, if handling is good, if storage is good, then you call that facility as a warehouse. And the last one is distribution center. So even distribution center is going to store goods. So basically godown, warehouse, distribution center, all these are going to store products. But the difference between this warehouse and distribution center is, so in a distribution center, the goods are stored and redistributed to other satellite warehouses. And from there, it may go to the customer. This is one. Second very important thing, when you call at as a distribution center, it also does some additional value-added services like fulfillment, packaging, labeling, or even cross-docking, right? Some value-added services are included part of it. Then you call that as a distribution center. Now, these are all the standard terms, but depending upon different industries, they call it in a different way. For example, e-commerce. A distribution center is called as a fulfillment center. They won't call it as a warehouse or a distribution center. They call it as a fulfillment center. What is the role of a fulfillment center? Same. They get all the products from sellers. They store it in the fulfillment center. Once a customer order come, you are going to pick it, pack it, and deliver it to the customer, right? Same role, whatever I just said in terms of a distribution center. But e-commerce industry predominantly call that as a fulfillment center. Like that, once you know the standards, you should be able to then decode it to very specific to any industry. Okay, so now you are clear on the godown versus warehouse versus distribution center. And the last one is warehousing. So warehouse means it is a place. Warehousing means it becomes like an activity. Okay, so what you call this as an warehousing is nothing but the process of storing goods. And very specifically, this process has three main activities, namely inbound, storage, and outbound. There are some other words you can use it. The inbound can be also called as inward. The storage can also be called as inventory. The outbound can be also called as outwards. Okay. Now, don't worry if you didn't understand, okay, what is inward, what is inbound, no issues at all. Next video, part of this topic, warehousing, is going to be detailed process within each of these main activities. I'll be explaining step by step, right from a shipment coming at the gate of the warehouse till it gets into the storage and order coming in till it is out of the warehouse. This complete thing I will explain it, but in the next video. So you need to stay tuned on the channel to view the next video. And if you are going to come in again at some point of time, please go straight to the playlist Supply Chain Fundamentals. All these videos on supply chain basics will be stored on that. Okay, so thank you so much. So that's it on this session. I hope you understood everything. If you have any comments or any questions, feel free to just write down on the comment section. I will be glad to answer them back. Not just that, in case you are still confused which are all the prerequisite videos before I watch this, I have also given those links down in the description of this video. Make use of them, keep learning. Let's learn and grow in supply chain. Thank you so much.